to the jungle. In the city of lights, yeah. In the backstreet balls, in the neon lights, yeah. Life Air Rescue is the premier medical flight transport company in Northwest Louisiana and is operated through a joint effort involving the MedTrans Corporation and Shreveport's very own Metro Aviation. Life Air responds with multiple agencies throughout the Arklatex, as well as operations with numerous hospitals. The EC-135 is the biggest in the area and one of the few capable of carrying multiple patients, as well as a specialized NICU transport unit. Life Air is outfitted with some of the most sophisticated equipment in the region and capable of everything from interfacility transports to EMS scenes involving local fire and EMS agencies.
Roger, your ground contact is going to be 246 on CSO South.
My name is Paige Keene, and I'm the program director for Life Air Rescue. I've been at this program for, it'll be 2 years in June. So my role as program director of Life Air Rescue is to get out into the community and let them know that we're here, to have a team aspect. We have what we call shared governance team, where each team member is very involved with our program. So Travis does our education, Gordon does our QA, QI. So it's really more of a team aspect with Life Air Rescue. We're one big happy family, really. When we look at new people to join our team, we also look at their how well they will fit with our team and also, you know, what they can bring to us. We at Life Air Rescue, when we go out and do ground schools, LZ training with all the, you know, EMS agencies that call us, we do like them to early activate us because we like to go ahead and get in the air with outside of that 30-mile radius. Some places will go ahead and launch just so we can be to the patient the quickest way or the quickest time that we can get there. But it is good to get us there because there may be like a long extrication that we can go ahead and start the care on the patient while you guys, the EMS agencies and the fire departments, are working on getting that patient out.
My name is Pamela Anderson. I've been with Life Air, a nurse with Life Air Rescue for 25 years. Well, first of all, our job requirement is 5 years for a nurse. You have to have 5 years experience as a nurse, preferably in ER and ICU. Once you get on the helicopter, you get your training, working around the helicopter, working in the helicopter, but you're also required to get extra credentials. Of course, you have to have ACLS, PALS, TNCC, ENPC. You have to have an advanced certification, certified flight nurse certification, certified flight paramedic for the medics. No, MedTrans provides us with a lot of education, and we have continuing ed on our computer that we're continuously working on to keep up with. And that may be anything related to trauma, sepsis, stroke, MI, physiology, flight safety. There's numerous things that we're continuously being educated about and re-educating. LVADs, Impella devices, different things like that. And we do our quarterly sim lab.
I'm Tracy King. I've been a nurse since 2007, and I've been working with Life Air Rescue for 3 years. So my transition from being a nurse to working at Life Air Rescue, it's been very interesting. And I think it is for a lot of nurses in my situation that didn't have pre-hospital experience. It's very exciting. You know, we get out on scene and there's a lot to see that you just can't wrap your mind around when you're, you know, in the walls of a hospital. I mean, I came from a unit that didn't have any windows. So now I get to experience this, being outside, which is wonderful. And, you know, learning a lot about scene safety and working with a paramedic is invaluable in that sense as well. And also, I worked 12-hour shifts in the hospital, but never 24s before. And now we work a combination of 12 and 24-hour shifts. My husband works 24s. I mean, you can march his schedule out through the end of the year because he's a Shreveport fireman, even next year. And now it adds a very interesting dynamic to our family because I'm working the 24-hour shifts. He's working the 24-hour shifts. I think right now, during this 36-hour span, right now we had 2 hours where we saw each other in passing. And, you know, we've got two kids. And my daughter last night was asking me, she goes, will Daddy be here when I wake up in the morning? I said, yes, Daddy will be here part of the day. And she said, will you be here? And I was like, no, I won't be here. So she's old enough to understand. She knows what we do, but she's not very excited about what we do. You know, she's much more excited to talk to a hairdresser than she is. I mean, she doesn't care I'm on a helicopter, but if you introduce her to a hairstylist, she wants to talk to him all day long. That's exciting to a four-year-old. Not fire trucks, not helicopters. But if you can turn somebody's hair pink, she's your girl. I wish we sat around and watched TV. When we're not flying, we are, you know, actually flying might be the easiest part these days because we get to utilize the skills that we train for the rest of the time. And the training, it's endless. And it's something I hesitate to say warn people about when they step into this. We warn them in an encouraging way. Like, if you're ready to be challenged, this is the place to be because we're advancing all the time. We're always adding equipment, but for all the right reasons, you know, to save patients, to be the best at what we do, to be the only aircraft in the state that's utilizing onboard ultrasound, the only aircraft with the blood. And it takes a lot of training to do those fast scans with the ultrasound equipment. And I mean, that's just a little bit of the equipment we have and the training, and we're always adding new skills, and it doesn't end there. You can't get rusty. And the continuing education is what I was the most excited about, but I had no idea how much it was going to be. It's a lot of continuing education, and it never gets old and never gets stale. We've been here over 30 years, Life Air Rescue has, and never in that time have we seen so much growth. It's wonderful.
My name is Britt Gunn. I'm a flight paramedic, Life Air Rescue. I've been here since June of 2015. Pamela. I wanted to come fly with Miss Pam, right there.
Now you're supposed to say Pamela Anderson.
Pamela Anderson. Provides a more, in some cases, a more challenging patient. Because it's cool.
That's what I was about to say. Because it's cool.
Because you don't want new ground transport?
Because it's in a helicopter. I don't know if you knew that, but it's in a helicopter. So we get here, we shift change at 6:15 in the morning. We'll come in, we'll get a briefing from the off-going crew. We'll change our blood out, make sure that, you know, there's nothing important that we need to know from the off-going crew. And then we'll go to the aircraft, and we'll check all of our equipment, make sure we have all of our tubes, blades, that our vent works properly, our monitor works properly, that we have just basically everything that we need to take care of a critically ill or injured patient.
Earl.
A critically ill or injured patient.
We're one of, I believe, 5 in the country. We're the only in the state with this, with onboard ultrasound, which this is the same ultrasound that some smaller hospitals use in their ERs, their primary ultrasound.
Yeah, Andy Goldthorpe. I've been with Life Air Rescue now for 10 months. Before that, I flew with another program in Arkansas for 21 years. I think the outreach that we do, like you said, as an example, Shattered Dreams, is just tremendous. The fact that we're able to get out there on a daily basis with the community and certainly can make an impact, whether it's a landing zone class, whether we're teaching education, or whether we're participating in an operation like that. I think that, you know, even if it saves one life or if we can educate people to save lives, I think that it's greatly beneficial to everybody. You know, when I came to this program, even though I had experience elsewhere, I mean, everything is just to the next level. As far as education, they've really focused in on education. I've had more education probably in the last 10 months than I've had in the last few years. Safety absolutely is paramount.
My name is Travis Schultz. I'm one of the flight nurses. I'm also the educator for Life Air Rescue, and I got hired at the end of 2005, so I've been flying for about the last 11 years. Okay, so as the educator for Life Air Rescue, I'm responsible for making sure that everybody's certifications are kept up to date. Also, I set up the simulation labs. We're required quarterly to go to a simulation lab. It allows us to pretty much practice high-risk, low-volume type patients. So, and procedures that we don't get a lot of practice of, but they're higher risk. It allows us to practice and make mistakes there as opposed to making them in the real world. We also do a lot of outreach education to EMS agencies and try to, you know, provide education to them so that we can better the level of care that they're giving their patients as well. Well, one of the biggest differences, obviously, is the space that you have to work in. And, you know, we try to be able to provide the same level of care that the ICU is providing. So if we pick up an ICU patient, we, you know, attempt to give the same level of care that they're getting there. So obviously it complicates things because we're in a smaller space and, you know, we're working, you know, in a smaller area. So it, obviously it's going to complicate our ability to be able to do that. You know, you're also flying in an aircraft as opposed to working, you know, in a hospital. So you have changes that you look at. There's flight physiology changes that'll happen with the patient. And so, and also when things change with the patient, it tends to be more rapid. You know, they're usually sicker patients or they're already very sick, so they can deteriorate very quickly. Well, I mean, we always say that, you know, we're a family, you know, at Life Air Rescue, and we do anything for each other. And, you know, it's just that, it is family.
We're scheduled 24 into 12, but this is not a 36-hour a week job. I mean, there's always something going on that people step up to the plate and do as a team.
You know, the camaraderie. I mean, it's just a great organization to work with, and you know, proud every day to put on this flight suit.
I mean, I honestly believe that we have a great family dynamic here. And we've got people like Pam that, I mean, she is Life Air Rescue. We've got people that have worked in this program forever, and we're all from here.